Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today we're gonna learn how to use Tailwind CSS to develop some great looking websites. As you advance as a developer, you're more likely to use technologies that help you do more by writing less code. A solid front-end framework like Tailwind CSS is one way to accomplish that. In this video, we'll learn about Tailwind CSS. We'll start by explaining how to install and integrate Tailwind CSS in your project, see some practical applications, and also how you can create your custom styles and plugins. Of course, before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, now, what is Tailwind CSS? Tailwind CSS is a utility-first CSS or cascading style sheets framework with predefined classes that you can use to build and design web pages directly in your markup. It lets you write CSS in your HTML in the form of predefined classes. Now, what is a framework? A general programming term, a framework is a tool that provides reusable and ready-made components built from the features of an already existing tool. The overall purpose of creating frameworks is to increase development speed by doing less work. Now that we've established the meaning of a framework, it should help you understand that Tailwind CSS is a tool built upon CSS features. All the framework's functionalities were derived from CSS styles and composed as classes. When we say utility-first CSS, we refer to classes in our markup, HTML, with predefined functionalities. This implies that you only have to write a class with predefined styles attached to it, and those styles will be applied to the element. In a case where you're working with vanilla CSS, or CSS without any framework or library, you would first give your element a class name, and then attach different properties and values to that class, which will, in turn, apply styling to your element. Let's look at an example. Here, we'll create a button with rounded corners and a text that says, "Click me." Here's what the button will look like. We'll first do this using vanilla CSS, and then using utility classes available in Tailwind CSS. We've given button tags to the class button, which will be styled using an external style sheet as seen here. Now, here's what this looks like if we were writing code with Tailwind CSS. This is all required to achieve the same effect as the example with vanilla CSS. No external style sheet where you have to write the styles was created because each class name we already used has a predefined style. Now, before using Tailwind CSS, there are some prerequisites that you should consider meeting to use the framework's features without difficulties. Good knowledge of HTML, its structure, and how it works. A solid foundation in CSS, media queries, flexbox, and grid system. And take note, you can use Tailwind CSS in front-end web projects, including JavaScript frameworks like React.js, Next.js, Laravel, Vite, Gatsby, and more. Before installing Tailwind CSS and integrating it in your project, make sure that you have Node.js installed on your computer to make use of the Node package manager in the terminal. And your project is all set up with your files created. This is what our project structure looks like at the moment. Next, start up a terminal for your project and run the following commands. This command will install the Tailwind CSS framework as a dependency. Next, generate your tailwind.config.js file by running this command. The tailwind.config.js file will be empty when created, so we have to add some lines of code. The file paths provided in the content array will enable Tailwind to purge or remove any unused styles during build time. The next thing to do is to add the @tailwind directives to your CSS file in the SRC folder. This is where Tailwind generates all of its predefined utility styles for you. The last thing to do is to start the build process by running this command in your terminal. In this code, we're telling Tailwind that our input file is the style sheet in the SRC folder, and that whatever styles we've used have to be built into the output file in the public folder. Including watch in this command allows Tailwind to watch your file for changes for an automatic build process. Omitting it means we've to run that script every time we want to build our code and see the desired output. Now that we've installed and set up Tailwind CSS for our project, let's see some examples to understand its application fully. To use Flex in Tailwind CSS, you need to add a class of Flex and then the direction of the Flex items. Using Flex Row Reverse will reverse the order in which the buttons appear. Using Flex Col stacks them above each other. When specifying columns and rows in the grid system, we take a different approach by passing in a number that will determine how the elements will occupy available space. Tailwind comes with a lot of predefined colors. Each color has a set of different variations, with the lightest variation being 50 and the darkest being 900. Here is a picture of multiple colors and their HTML hex codes to illustrate this. Here's an example of how you can do this using the red color to give a button element a background color. This syntax is the same for all colors in Tailwind, except for black and white, which are written the same way, but without the use of numbers. BG-black and BG-white. To add text color, you use text color class as seen here. Tailwind already has a design system that would help you keep a consistent scale across your designs. All you have to know is the syntax for applying each utility. The following are utilities for adding padding to your elements. P denotes padding across the whole element. PY denotes padding, padding top, and padding bottom. PX denotes padding left and padding right. PT denotes padding top, PR denotes padding right, PB denotes padding bottom, and PL denotes padding left. To apply them to your elements, you'll have to use the appropriate numbers provided by Tailwind, a bit similar to the numbers that represented color variants in the last section. Here's what we mean. The predefined utilities for padding and margin are very similar. All you have to do is replace the P with an M. Even though Tailwind CSS has loads of utilities and design systems already built for you, it's still possible that you may have a particular functionality that you would like to add to extend what Tailwind can be used for. Tailwind CSS allows you to do this by creating a plugin. Let's get our hands dirty by creating a plugin that adds the aqua color and a rotate utility that rotates an element 150 degrees on the x-axis. We'll make these utilities in the tailwind.config.js file using a little bit of JavaScript. Now, let's break this down. The first thing we did was to import Tailwind's plugin function. Then we went on to create our plugins in the plugins array. You might have to rerun the build script after making your plugin. Now that the plugins are ready, we can test them. If you did everything right, you should have a button with an aqua color with the text rotated to 150 degrees on the x-axis. Frameworks are an invaluable option when it comes to speeding up your workflow. They help you build good-looking and professional web pages while maintaining consistency in design. Tailwind CSS provides many utility-forward CSS classes to help take your web design and development to the next level. Have you used Tailwind CSS or another CSS framework in the past? Share your thoughts in the comments section. Looking for a quality local development solution? With Dev Kinsta, in a single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress projects from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use, even if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.